So you can see that this water is exactly the same as the reservoir. So if I was to, say, move this around, now I'm just gonna hang it on this guy's toolbox right here. And watch the water level. It is just climbing, slowly but surely. And once it stops, that is exactly level with where I set that water over there in the reservoir. So a water level or hydro level, what is it and how does it work? So it's basically like this bowl of water I drew here is an excellent level. No matter what I do, if I was to turn the bowl like this in parallel with the ground, the water would level itself out automatically. Same the other way, it'll always level out. Only problem is I'm not putting a project into this thing or into a pond or a lake. That's ridiculous, but you can build something. Now this is pretty neat. It's just a water reservoir, bucket, jug, whatever you have, and a hose attached to it. This reservoir and the hose is filled with water, and you leave this, you can fill the water or drop the water level height to whatever height you want your objects, and leave that still after you set it. Then you can move this hose anywhere you like, and the water will always fill back up to this exact line. So this can be used in the place of a transit. It can be used in the place of multiple types of levels. And this gives you an extended range. And also, like a laser requires direct line of sight. If you don't have direct line of sight, you're working in the woods or under a building, you need a water level. So let's build one. Okay, so what we're gonna use to make the hydro level are a few simple things right here from the shop. But one thing I did get online is a bulkhead fitting. Like I said, down below in the description will be a link to these bulkhead fittings. It's just a fitting so you can run something through bulkhead, or in this case, a bottle, and keep a tight seal, no leaks. Coupling, threaded brass. This is an air hose from just sitting around the shop. And we also, just a piece of clear hose. This one already has like a little hose barb on it, so that's pretty handy. This will be for the end of our hose, so we can see the water level. Then just a jug, just laying around the shop. So first thing I'm gonna do is get my connections made. So we'll just tighten that up real quick. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and put this clear hose on the end. All right, now this is a fancy tool. People are gonna just be so proud of your work if you build something like this. And this is optional. This is just a piece of copper wire. And this is something I can attach to here. And I can use this to hook onto something. Oh yeah, that'll hold it up. Now that this end is done, let's set it out of the way. Oh yeah. Okay, so this bulkhead fitting is pretty cool. It's got two gaskets and then this clamp on the backside, this nut that tightens it down. So the first thing we want to do with the jug is we're going to cut a little opening right here so we can reach inside. Now, please don't be like me. Use gloves, safety equipment at all times. I don't want you getting hurt and having injuries like me. Now let's get a hole in our jug. Okay, so that fits nicely and you can see our gasket. We'll fit flush, and then we can just stick the gasket on the backside and the nut and tighten it down. Okay, now we're just gonna put the nut on it. Now we have a fancy, high quality hydro level. All right, so I'm gonna show you the fill procedure. You just wanna put your reservoir on something high like this. Let's go ahead and add a whole bunch of fluid to it. So I'm using RV antifreeze, half RV antifreeze and half water. What's nice about this is if I'm using outside in the cold, this water level, it won't freeze on me. And then I have higher visibility with this pink color. And it's biodegradable, so that's good. Okay, so what you want to do is lift the hose up like this, and you'll see this water. I don't know if you guys can see this, but the water is starting to come up. It's leveling with our jug, the water level in that jug over there. So what I'm going to do is just slowly but surely walk this down the way. Just repeat this step, walking it down like this until you get to the end of the line. So now the water has been bled all the way down to the end. There's our water. Now I'm going to put my thumb on the end of this so I don't lose any water, and that'll hold a vacuum on it. See, that water can't move. I'm going to walk over to our reservoir and we'll show you this. But as you can see, the water wants to return to the exact height of the reservoir. It's pretty cool. So no matter where I take this hose, as long as the end is open where it can get air, it's always gonna level out to the same exact spot. I mean, that is dead on. So you got a water level. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later.